Environmental scientists in Abu Dhabi have just launched a detailed study of the Emirates' biodiversity and ecosystems. The results will become a crucial tool for planning and development in the decades to come, as Noni Edwards reports.
The Environment Agency Abu Dhabi is embarking on its biggest information gathering exercise to date, the Terrestrial Baseline Survey. Launched here at the Al Wathba Wetland Reserve, it's an ambitious project to document every type of plant and animal in the emirate, comparing that with information already gathered using satellite imaging.
The objective of the survey is to really come up with a thorough understanding, a comprehensive understanding of the terrestrial ecosystem that we as an agency are mandated to protect.
It's a mission that the agency is taking very seriously, and they're going to need help. School and community groups will take part in field observations and wildlife surveys, and amateur naturalists will be asked to report their findings too. Ultimately, the agency will work out precisely what kinds of flora and fauna exist and where.
So it's going to take about 2 years to collect all that information to get a comprehensive coverage of all the plants and animals across the whole emirate. So it's a long-term survey. And so before we've got 55,000 square kilometres to cover in that period.
In order to work out a baseline, the studies need to be repeated over several seasons. From there, scientists can work out the rate of environmental change and the effects of human disturbance and feral species on the emirate's native wildlife populations.
This information is critical. It's critical for agencies like the environment agencies that are mandated to protect biodiversity. It is important because we would know where the collections of the most important species in terms of both numbers and types.
Work has already begun collecting data in the desert of Abu Dhabi's western region, but eventually the inventory will cover the entire emirate and every type of habitat, from subtidal areas to salt marsh to dune fields. One of the main reasons this information is important is that it will allow Abu Dhabi's urban planners to have a clearer picture of which areas are most suitable for future development.
We need to understand what we have out in the environment so we can plan to protect or build around it or mitigate when we are developing. So, and the decision makers and the planners need to know this information before they start identifying areas for development.
But it also enables us to really assess some of our existing management strategies. Have we been able to be successful in preservation of biodiversities, and where are the areas that would need improvement?
The survey has been designed according to international standards and is being conducted in cooperation with the Abu Dhabi Global Environmental Data Initiative. Noni Edwards, Emirates News.